Talk to police officers and they'll tell you. In addition to providing ballistic protection, body armor needs to be comfortable, accommodating officers of all shapes and sizes. Blocking bullets may be job one, but proper fit is high on the list of priorities, according to Lieutenant Brandi Adamchik, U.S. Park Police. She's a member of the National Institute of Justice's Special Technical Committee working on revising the Ballistic Resistance of Body Armor Standard and a participant in a focus group on women's body armor issues.
The optimal female body armor would be one that's more comfortable, breathable, flexible, and easy to wear every day, user-friendly, a user-friendly vest that we could go out on patrol and wear with our other equipment that provides the maximum protection and coverage that we need in order for us to survive.
The Bureau of Justice Statistics estimates that female police officers make up 20% of the force and are represented across all types of agencies. Of the 3,180 ballistic armor saves recorded by the IACP DuPont Survivors Club, many are female officers. To maximize officer safety, NIJ's compliance testing program certifies women's vest models separately from similar men's models. In the 15 years that she's been on the job, Lieutenant Adamchik says she's seen improvements to female body armor, but she says more can be done. She describes an ongoing problem that the industry is addressing.
When a female officer receives a vest from a vendor, it's not fitting properly. It's an ill-fit vest, and there seems to be very vague explanation as to why that female vest, when it was specifically measured for that officer, does not fit properly when it's received. So I think more education needs to happen in the process of measurement, production, and end product.
Ill-fitting vests can be more than an annoyance. Design elements such as darts and folds in female vests can cause them to be bulky, restricting movement and causing gaps under arms that may make officers more vulnerable. The technical committee continues to collect information and communicate with the industry to make improvements. Lieutenant Adamchik acknowledges that body armor is an important piece of safety equipment and encourages all police officers to find the right vest for their maximum protection. Body armor saves lives. It can also make everyday police work safer.
I fortunately have not encountered a situation where I had to count on my body armor for my life and safety. But I will say that there has been an incident. I am a horse mounted patrol officer, and during the course of my patrol, I had an incident with the horse where I fell off the horse and the horse ultimately landed right on top of me and rolled off of me. And I believe that in wearing my vest, it was that extra layer of protection that prevented me from further injury and harm.